The project is called Advanced Urban Air Mobility Technology Testbeds. This is a new effort in aeronautics to look at urban flight, both unmanned flight, so package delivery type vehicles, all the way up to manned vehicles that may carry 6 or 8 people at one time. Most of it is vertical takeoff and landing flight. So at times you're hovering, and then at other times you're transitioning into fast forward flight. And that handoff between hovering and forward flight is really difficult from a control standpoint. And NASA is starting to look at these concepts and how you would fly them in the airspace and how you would help all of these companies that are working on them get their vehicles certified and airworthy and safe to fly. So we're building these technology test beds to investigate those things. We'll be working with flight control companies, with airframe designers, with the FAA. This is all about getting the data and getting the process down so that we can help the private sector and accelerate the whole urban air mobility effort.
The focus initially was to try to build as much of the aircraft as we could using 3D printers. We'll go straight from the CAD file to getting printed out. Less hands-on work for the parts.
We were trying to do a quick design iteration, test it, and then go back around the design cycle. So the LA-8 vehicle would be the first one of a series of vehicles where we would continually increase our performance and our learning.
We've already figured out a lot of things that we would like to do a little different on the second and third models, which are under construction now. And so I'm making changes in the CAD files as we go along. And if you need some replacement parts, you can almost just push a button and get a part printed out.
This new vehicle that we've built now is about 80% 3D printed material. Even though it might look like some of the concepts out there, it's really meant to be a modular vehicle where you can change the wings, you can change the fuselage, and you can do that very rapidly.
A lot of different UAM type technologies can be used on this as a test bed.
NASA is really focusing on how do you make these types of vehicles safer? How do you look at off-nominal conditions? Off-nominal meaning what if you lost a propeller or motor? Could you still control the vehicle and get it on the ground safely? Can you fly this in gusty winds? These are areas that we're building these technology test beds for.